From Dad's and Ashley's points of view, everything around the Platinum Raven fades in brightness and volume. Her stature's growth is shocking. Soon she is twice the size of either of them, eyeing them with a terrible understanding, like a Cyclops glaring down in monstrous singularity over a bank of rocks and vegetation. They would be still more shocked if they knew how she is seeing them, for whenever she looks at humans in this way, she sees them as organisms or growths on the floor of a valley, in the form of tentacles, roots, legs, or branches, each of an appropriate texture, color, shape, length, flexibility, and opacity. Some of these people organisms are huge, some at ease, some are weak or alluring in their delicacy, while it's evident that others are pitiful, painful structures to inhabit, with all their spines facing inward. The strongest, most intelligent and sensitive ones often have a tough skeleton beneath their tentacles, but a surface coated with hair-like processes that convey minute sensations too. Others seem little more than fluff or bone. Dard, she therefore sees as a creature reminiscent of a cheap plastic gnome, something from which to evolve in theory, but whose misplaced self-satisfaction has short-circuited any desire for evolution and thus any capacity for it. Ashley, on the other hand, she sees as a lazy and frightened little fool of a figurine, albeit a polished one, huddling behind the gnome. Jamie slaps the steering wheel in pleasure, sitting in the car on Blue Jay Way. Oh, he knows how she feels.